Hello everyone, in this video we have one square and this length is given 6, here is given 2 root 5, this length is given 2 root 10, and the question is, what is the area of the square? Okay. First of all, let's call one side of the square x unit, and here let's call alpha. That means this angle must be equal 90 minus alpha, right? Okay. After that, for this triangle, if we apply cosine rule, so 6 squared equal x squared plus 2 root 10 whole squared minus 2 times x times 2 root 10 times cosine alpha, right? So 36 equal x squared plus 40 minus 4x times root 10 times cosine alpha. So 4x root 10 times cosine alpha equal x squared plus 4. That means cosine alpha equal x squared plus 4 over 4x root 10. Okay. Now also for this triangle, if we apply cosine rule, two root 5 whole squared equal 2 root 10 whole squared plus x squared minus 2 times 2 root 10 times x times cosine 90 minus alpha, right? Therefore, 20 equal 40 plus x squared minus 4x root 10 times, we know that cosine 90 minus alpha equal sine alpha, right? So 4x root 10 times sine alpha equal x squared plus 20. That means sine alpha equal x squared plus 20 over 4x root 10. Okay. Let me create here. After that, if you square both sides of the equations like this, then if we add these two equations together, so sine squared alpha plus cosine squared alpha equal x squared plus 4 over 4x root 10 whole squared plus x squared plus 20 over 4x root 10 whole squared, right? Okay. You know that value of this expression equal 1. And if you organize the equation, we get x squared plus 4 whole squared plus x squared plus 20 whole squared equal 160 times x squared, right? I want to represent x squared with m. Therefore, m plus 4 whole squared plus m plus 20 whole squared equal 160 times m. Therefore, m squared plus 8m plus 16 plus m squared plus 14 plus 400 equal 160 m. Okay. Let's clear here. So m squared, 2m squared plus 8m, 40m minus 160m equal minus 112m plus 416 equals 0. Then if we divide by 2 both sides of the equations, we get m squared minus 56m plus 208 equals 0, right? So m squared equals m times m, and 208 equals minus 52 times minus 4. Therefore, m minus 52 times m minus 4 equals 0. That means m equals 52 and m equal 4. We called m as x squared, right? That means x squared equals 52 and x squared equal 4. But x can't be 2. I will explain it. Therefore, square area equal x squared. So x squared equal 52 units squared. So let me explain why x can't be 2. Let's clear here. X can't be 2 because notice that, let's draw the diagonal of the square. If x equal 2, diagonal of the square must be equal to root 2, right? If you focus on triangle ADC, let's draw here. Here is 2, here is 2, hypotenuse is 2 root 2, and this length 2 root 5, right? And let's draw the other length, 2 root 10, this length, let's remind you, if you have a triangle, and let's call these two sides X and Y, and let's call A and B, the other two sides. We know that the sum of A and B must be greater than the sum of X and Y. Therefore, if in the given question, one side of the square is 2, this equation will be violated, so X can't be 2. Now also, we will calculate value of x using second method. First of all, let's extend this two corner and let's call here a. And for this square, if we apply the British flag theorem, a squared plus 2 root 10 whole squared must be equal 6 squared plus 2 root 5 whole squared, right? Therefore, a squared plus 40 equal 36 plus 20. So a squared equals 16. That means A is going to be 4 units. let's write here 4, and let's call here alpha and theta. We know that these two sides are equal, right? And if you move this triangle to the bottom side of the square, here is also alpha, and this length is also 4, and here is also 2 root 5, right? We know that alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees. That means here must be equal 90 degrees. And if we connect these two corners, this angle must be equal 45 degrees, right? So if you focus on this triangle, if there's a 40 in it, opposite of the 45 degrees, opposite of the 90 degrees must be equal 4 root 2, right? After that, if you focus on this triangle, let's call here theta. For this triangle, if we apply cosine rule, we get the value of theta, right? Let's call here point K. For triangle BEK, if we apply cosine rule, therefore 2 root 5 whole squared equal 6 squared plus 4 root 2 whole squared minus 2 times 6 times 4 root 2 times cosine theta. So 20 equal 36 plus 32 minus 48 root 2 times cosine theta. Therefore, 48 root 2 times cosine theta equal 48. If you simplify, that means cosine theta equal 1 over root 2, right? Therefore, theta equal 45 degrees. If theta equal 45 degrees, that means triangle BEC is a right triangle. Therefore, for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, 4 squared plus 6 squared, let's call one side of square B. So B squared, that means B squared equal 52. So the square area equal 52 units square. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye bye.